Well, I probably started because I loved the stock market, and my dad offered me a seat on the New York Stock Exchange. And he didn't really want it for me, he wanted it for himself, but he did not want to live in New York. So I was the kid who could move. And I'm sorry I didn't take him up on it. I did not, but I do love the stock market. And I'm kind of an idiot savant, a stock picker, which is a great thing because not everybody has that ability. And so I was able to make a fair amount of change doing that. And I don't think that has much to do with your intelligence or lack thereof. I think it's a gift. Because I had a brilliant brother who couldn't do what I could do. And he just didn't have the gift of being a stock picker. So I did, and I'm grateful for it. It got me where I am. Without that, I would not have got here. Well, of course, I'm an artist. And so I studied extensively in various fields. I'm a painter, won awards for my work, and I flirted with architecture, and of course I'm a designer. I happily design anything. I'll happily design a garden, a house, a room, and a pretty good couturier. I wanted to go to Paris for that. I got high praise from a man whose works, he was an architect, and his works are among the National Historic Monuments, or whatever you call it, the National Trust for Historic Monuments. I mean, he did two buildings that are. One was the Pickwick Theater in the Park Ridge, and the other was Maine East High School. And they're both rather legendary buildings. And the other one was a sculptor. And they just so thoroughly enjoyed a painting that I had done that the sculptor wanted to do a bust of me in return for a portrait of him. So those were really the major thrills, because I think it takes somebody in your own field to praise you before you really feel you've accomplished anything. And that's pretty much what happened to me. Well, I thought that was pretty exciting, to be praised by other people in the field. And that was in art. And then, of course, I'm also an environmentalist. You know, I hope that I've been a good steward of my land, both in Park Ridge and up here. And what does that mean? Well, that means not using any herbicides, because I'm at war with them. I think they do more harm than they do good. And I'm at war with one particular one because it does cause certain cancers. And unfortunately, one of my dogs succumbed to that one. She didn't get it at my place. She got it down in Florida because she was a show dog, and she was shown in every state east of the Mississippi River. So on some of the show sites, apparently, some of the herbicides have been used. So it takes a while for it to happen, and she ultimately succumbed to it. This one causes lymphoma, and it's a terrible thing, and they should not allow it to be manufactured, let alone used. I am also very interested in wetlands, because I doubt if people realize how valuable they are. And if we block off all the wetlands, and so you have a totally dry environment, your water will not be cleared. So they're having a problem now in Iowa with just that. They blocked off too many of the wetlands, and now they've got water that they cannot even drink. And people have no idea what they're doing. They're doing it in utter innocence, but it does great damage. I think one of the great blessings of our day is probably organic gardening, because you're improving the environment, you're not harming it. And I cannot praise the people highly enough who go out and literally spend their days doing that sort of work. It's not easy, but they do it. And we're all better off for it, and so is the environment. My mother was a brilliant woman who should have been Secretary of State. I'd never known a woman with a grasp of world affairs that my mother had. And then, of course, my father was a brilliant fellow who had many interests, and felt that even though I was the only girl in the family, I should be able to do anything my brothers could do, which was nice because not all fathers feel that way about their daughters. I think they think, well, you know, kind of second-class citizens, maybe. But my dad was not like that. He expected me to do whatever I wanted to do. And of course, my great desire was to have been a doctor. And I was thwarted by that, by my own illness, so I couldn't do that. And that I'm sorry about, but I would have loved that. We had no children. I did breed dogs, and I bred 8 champions, which is quite an accomplishment. I could be a judge because the criteria for being a judge is you must have bred 2 champions. I bred 8, and a couple of them were entered at Westminster. One was a No. 2 miniature poodle in Canada for the year 2003. While there, he sired 32 puppies, and I had one of them, and a sweeter, nicer dog never lived than little Shirley. And I have her grandchildren now. And so that has been a very interesting thing for me because I do love my dogs, and they were just such a wonderful part of my life. And once I had the puppies, I no longer did any painting. I didn't have time. I mean, you cannot paint with a house full of dogs. I just found that to be the case. So that was the end of that. But one of the last things I did was that portrait of me over there. Take whatever talent you have, make the most of it, and live each day as it comes. Because all you have is this moment. Yesterday's gone, you can't get it back. Tomorrow may never come, so do the best you can with whatever time you have today. I would think that's about the best I could say. That's what I've tried to do. I don't know, I suppose, as a person who tried to be useful and helpful. I mean, you can always help people. You can help the environment. I've tried to do both. And certainly I've helped the animal kingdom. You know, I have deer up here and I just love them. It breaks my heart to think that there are people out there who could shoot them with bows and arrows, as well as guns. I have foxes up here, and I have chipmunks like you would not believe. Ugh. They are so cute, but they do so much damage. I wish they would go somewhere else, but they have not. So I guess I'm stuck with them.